All right, next up is Nathan Keller about a joint paper with Itai Dunar. It should be Itai Dunar according to our information, but it seems to have changed. Also, the title has changed. So when this was submitted to us, you can see on the title, it was synchronizing optimally. Apparently, in the meantime, it changed to how to synchronize efficiently.
And then maybe after that, it'll be how to synchronize practically.
Yes, actually, we thought that the amendments we do until 3:30 will be reflected in the program. So both the name of the speaker and the title were changed before 3:30. Okay, anyway, so I'm going to speak about some new exam, which is about some simple and nice mathematical riddle, about some nice mathematics and some application to some nice things. So the motivation comes from homomorphic secret sharing. This is was introduced by Eyal Boyle and the Nevkel Boyle and Van Shai in Crypto 16 as a practical alternative to fully homomorphic encryption. It allows homomorphic evaluation of a function to be distributed among two parties who do not interact with each other. They constructed a group-based HSS scheme, but not for all functions, but those described by branching program. This was quite successful. It got best paper about crypto, then quite a few follow-up works in different conferences, many applications. Now, this is for those who understand what it is. Now, for those who do not, just look at the mathematical problem we have in it. So this was the main open problem in the paper of PGI. So the scheme is based on some shared conversion procedure, which has errors. And since it is repeated many times, then it is very important to reduce the probability of error. So this amounts to a clear mathematical problem, the following one. We have n random numbers arranged in line. We have two parties. They start in adjacent places on the line, but they do not know who of them is the first and who is the second. Now each one can query the lines at most in t places. They want to synchronize, that is to choose the same number but without any communication. So the question is, what is the minimal possible error probability? So here is a simple solution which was suggested by the authors. So we have here the sequence of numbers on the line. So each party queries just three consecutive points, starting with his points forward, and chooses the minimum. For example, we have t equal 5. Here, both players do it, and the minimum 11 is the common minimum for both, so they can synchronize. But if we replace the places of the first two numbers, then they do not synchronize because one of them chooses the first number and the other chooses another. Here it is clear that actually error occurs only if the minimum is in the end point, so the error probability is about 1 over t. The question is whether one can do better. So, this was open and several papers tried to improve it, but there was no asymptotic improvement. So here is our result. We show that first we present an algorithm which achieves error rate of 1 over t squared instead of 1 over t. And also we show a much lower bound, which shows that unless we can't find discrete log in a short interval faster than square root of the length of the interval, we cannot break this 1 over t squared bound. So currently for all standard cryptographic groups like LMDKs, etc., this is really optimal. At least we believe so. So the techniques are a mixture of nice mathematical techniques. It starts with some random walks with some funny numbers of steps and some fancy things. To prove that the random walks work, we use some martingale theory. And to prove the lower bound, we use some discrete Fourier analysis. So some nice mathematics involved. Now, applications, we get an asymptotic improvement of the computational complexity of that homomorphic secret sharing system. This is relevant applications like private integration and trivial and other things. So this appears in our paper in crypto. And now we are continuing to work on this, now with the original authors, with Eyal and Yuval, about algorithms which are outside cryptography to some string matching algorithms, some Boolean functions and that, and some more cool stuff. So I hope it's nice, and we really believe that this algorithm is quite generic, and so will be used in other places as well. So thanks.